Find the inverse function of the given function. Also state the domain and range of the function and the inverse function. Let's begin by determining the domain and range of the given function. And we'll go ahead and express the domain and range using interval notation. For the domain, remember, because we have the cube root of x, or because the index is odd, x can be any real number, positive, negative, or zero, and therefore the domain is all real numbers, which using interval notation is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. And since the output of the cube root of x is any real number, adding 4 doesn't change that, the range is also all real numbers. And now let's work on determining the inverse function. We begin by replacing g of x with y, giving us the same equation as y equals the cube root of x plus 4. Next, we interchange x and y to find the inverse equation. So the inverse equation is x equals the cube root of y plus 4. And now we need to solve for y. The first step is to isolate the cube root of y by subtracting 4 on both sides, which gives us x minus 4 equals the cube root of y. And now to solve for y, we need to undo the cube root by cubing both sides of the equation, which gives us the cube of x minus 4 equals the cube of the cube root of y. The right side simplifies to y, giving us the cube of x minus 4 equals y. For the last step, we replace y with f inverse of x, which indicates f inverse of x equals the cube of x minus 4. And now we need to state the domain and range of the inverse function, which is why it's always important to find the domain and range of the original function. Actually, going back to the inverse function, because this is g of x, this shouldn't be f inverse of x, it should be g inverse of x. And now the domain of g inverse of x equals the range of g of x. And the range of g inverse of x is equal to the domain of g of x, both of which are all real numbers. Before we go, let's check our work graphically by graphing g of x and g inverse of x on the same coordinate plane. Remember, when we graph a function and its inverse on the same coordinate plane, they should be reflections across y equals x. In blue, we have the graph of the original function, y equals x to the power of 1/3 plus 4. Notice how I use the rational exponent of 1/3 here instead of the cube root of x. I also graph the line y equals x as a dashed purple line, and then we also have the graph of the inverse function in red. Notice the two functions are reflections across y equals x, which verifies our inverse function is correct. I hope you found this helpful.